When you struggle, you expect reward at the end. When you struggle in your work or your school or your college, you expect that after I've struggled, I'm going to get paid for my work or I'm going to get rewarded for it. But what if a person struggles and still ends up in the hellfire? What does that mean? That means that the struggle that they did was in the totally wrong direction. Just because you struggled doesn't mean that you struggled right. You know, for example, if there's a person who's trying to push the wall and he keeps struggling against it, you might tell him, you're struggling, but it's not going to benefit you. You know, you're working, you're trying to push the wall down with your bare hands, it's not going to work. Better would be that you go out, struggle in this path, go out, talk to someone, get a bulldozer, tell him to knock the wall down, you can do it in a day, no problem. But you trying to push it, you can push it all your life and still not be able to knock the wall down. The point is, sometimes people are struggling in the wrong direction. They don't have the ability to think that, okay, this is the path that will actually benefit me. If I put my time in this, I'm going to get results. And I'm not just talking about, by the way, from a religious perspective. Even from a worldly perspective, you have to know how to struggle and where to struggle. For example, a person who might be playing, for example, video games all day, right? So if you're playing video games all day, you're also struggling. You're trying to get from one level to the next level. And the only benefit that will give you is that you have managed to successfully finish a game. But where are you in life? Nowhere. You might not be able to even earn the console on which you play through your own wealth. You might not be able to even buy the mobile phone with your own wealth if you spend all your time just playing games all day. You're struggling every day, you're playing, you're like, oh, I couldn't beat that guy, I'm playing all day. But this effort is not going to benefit you even in a worldly sense. Why? Because at the end of the day, you will not be able to afford this mobile phone. Because you have absolutely no skill except that you spend your time playing games. So the idea is, if you have struggled and used some of that, I'm not saying video games are haram or anything like that. You can play video games. But the point is that if that's all you do, then you're struggling in the wrong direction. You need to work on yourself. You need to earn for yourself. Once you start earning for yourself, then you can buy 10 of these, no problem. But you need to have a plan in place that's what I want to be in my life. That's what I want to do. And for that path, you have to struggle. You're not going to get it easy. Life isn't easy. You have to work hard. Even the greatest people who are entrepreneurs and leaders and businessmen, they work hard to get where they are. They weren't, they didn't strike gold or didn't find some buried treasure and they became rich overnight. They had to struggle for it. So inshallah, that's what we need to do for dunya, and that's what we need to do for akhirah.